back with Brandon once again. So have you found it's been, has it been a battle to play music that that is so unique as far as crossing so many boundaries as far as like style and the reality that there's not a lot of black hardcore bands that you're crossing so many racial lines pretty much. Do you think that's been harder for people to accept you or
harder?
No.
It's always easier at the end, or better at the end. And actually, what is easy? You
know? Yeah.
And I'm just like Guns N' Roses.
That's the core of the philosophy here. So, are you comfortable with the sort of cult following that you have? You know, I mean, would you try and get on a major label, or are you just comfortable with this sort of?
Here's our thing. John puts his way he wants to put us. Not our man, everybody in this room. It's like he brought me here to come and talk with us. And, you know, he's in control. We're just trying to do the right thing. This is the strength and the ability to do things. And, try to do the right
thing. So you just do what comes naturally. It's not
exactly.
Not calculated at all.
As long as your spirit's in the right place. And if it's not, hey, you know, you can learn. So that's what life's about.
Is touring like this a big drag for you? Or, I mean, is it something you look forward to?
Me personally, I love playing. If I'm not playing, it'll be in my house or on the road or wherever. It's a piece of my life missing. That's me. Everybody else has their personal.
I pretty much feel the same way.
So each little part, you know, you don't like, it's not hard to get you guys to go on tour. It's something with sort of the fact of life.
Yeah, absolutely.
So is this sort of a let's do some shows and see how it gets, or is this lineup, you know, fairly
let's just do some solid shows and get warmed up. Well,
to really use
my shows.
Do showcases and stuff like that.
Not showcases. It's just
warm up for regular tours and shit. Warm up, get ready, go make a record, and really go out. Trying to install some stamina in me.
Alright, well, what. You influence a lot of people, and I think a lot of those people want to know who influences you guys.
That was Barrow. Who influences me?
Interesting artist. I
can chase.
I first walked through the 87 Club on Avenue, 87th Street East. It's like a big metamorphosis of percussive energy just flowing through my life. Never since then, all I had endeavored to do was to create music in tandem with such a fine instrument.
Here, here, well spoken.
Do you find yourselves listening to a lot of fellow hardcore bands or not? Because there's not too many there.
Fellow hardcore bands.
Well, me personally, I like music that comes from the heart. Whatever kind of band, you know?
Mm.
You can listen to it and hear it in the music.
Alright, well, that's about all I have. The last question I have is what?
What happened to HR?
No. I already skipped that one.
Oh, what happened? But we want you to ask us that.
Ask it.
So yeah, what happened to HR? That's him right there. That's his cousin. This dude is his other brother. You got Earl and you got Chuck.
CM. Hudson.
Yes.
No, I don't know why I ask or nothing like that, but it's one of these things. To ask type of
no, well, you know, the one happened question I was going to ask is last time you played in Omaha,
right?
It was like a
some shit happened and I don't know.
The stage broke down.
The stage moved. I never went skydiving.
Surfing.
I've never had like no gravity, and for a second or two, played a couple notes.
Crowd
went forward and the stage. And
you weren't there?
I went like.
I was with it.
And the lights went over made a hat. He had a hat, you know. Nice lighting hat thing, you know, gel and everything fell on his head.
Yeah, on the head.
That was my other brother.
That was your Rasta brother, D.
So, all right. Well, thanks you guys for your time.
We really like Omaha.
Omaha likes you.